Today we are going to be working on getting users to, once they log in, that they get redirected to different places. So if a standard user logs in, they should be directed to the dashboard page like we set up early on. If they are an admin, then they should go to the admin dashboard page instead. Now, when Laravel 8 came out, it was a little bit of a controversy because there was no easy way of figuring out how to do this. So through a lot of Googling and some magic, okay, I came across this article where this gentleman, I think his name is Snapey, explains how to use conditional login redirect for Laravel 8. Okay, now if you take a look, you basically have to create a new login response class and then have basically your app use that to override the fortify login response that comes with the default setup. Okay, so he gives you a little bit of an explanation, and I think some of it might be outdated, but the basis for what I did is from this article. Okay, so what we're gonna do first is to show you what I mean. If we log in as, let's say I have a logged in user here, just a standard user, not a admin or anything, okay, and we log them in, they're gonna go to the dashboard page, okay? And the way we have it set up too is if now we log in as an admin, okay, so admin@admin.com password, okay, and then we log in, we also are going to go to the dashboard page, and we don't want that. Like, we want the admins to have access to this page, but we don't want this to be the admin's landing page. Okay, so let's head into our text editor and see what we see. To get to the login response for Laravel, for Fortify, we need to go deep into the app. So we'll go vendor, Laravel, Fortify, source, I believe it's HTTP, responses, okay, and then here's the login response that's currently set up. And as you can see, it just wants JSON, return two-factor false, redirect intended fortify home. And we know that our fortify home is dashboard. Okay, so this is what the app is actually using. Okay, so let's go ahead. We'll copy this out of here. We'll head back up to our app. We'll go to HTTP, we'll create a folder and we'll call it responses. Okay, and then now this we're going to call login response.php. So it'll be just like this one here. Okay, so press enter, open that up, and we can paste that. Okay, and now this will be Laravel Fortify contracts login response as login response contract, and now we'll be able to change whatever functionality we want in here. Okay, so since we are defining, we're going to be doing this based on role, we need to define the role. Okay, so the role equals auth user. And remember, this is just a shortcut for auth user. So normally it would be auth user, and then you'd have to import it up top, but we're not doing it that way. We're just going to use a shortcut so we don't have to import it. Okay, so auth user, and then we're going to say is admin. Okay, now we are going to, let's just comment this out for now. Okay, and then we'll put if request wants JSON. Okay, so just like it is here, but return response, And then we'll keep this two-factor. We can just copy this, save us some time. So copy, paste. So we'll just keep that. Now, if it's not, then we're going to look for certain roles. Okay, so we can use this one. So now we already have our variable up here, so we can just put in role. And in the first case, we're going to look for zero. And if it is zero, that means they're not a... And that means that they're not an admin. It means that they are a standard user. Then we'll return, redirect, and we'll keep intended, config, fortify, home. Okay. And all that fortify home is actually just coming from the... it's coming from the route service provider, which we have set up to dashboard. Okay, so I'm not going to show you that. I'm just going to leave it like that because we've already done that. So we'll copy this one. We'll paste it. And now in this case, if it's one, we can say return, redirect, and then we'll say route admin dashboard. And that's it. Okay, and then break. Now the default will be if they are neither user and they are or admin, then they're just gonna return, redirect back to the just standard page. Okay, so semicolon there. Now we can get rid of this. Now this login response needs to be registered somewhere. So where we would do that is in the providers, fortify service provider. But before we do that, let's go back to login response and make sure that this is correct. We need to change this back to app because we want to make sure that the namespace is pointing to the right place. So HTTP responses, and then it'll be login response. Okay, so now back to the Fortify service provider. Okay, we're going to come down to this boot method. And just under the boot method, we're going to create a new protected function. And the name of this function is going to be register response bindings. Okay, and we're going to name it like this because we are going to put in that that login response. And it's also good for if you also wanted to do it for the register routes or the logout routes or anything like that that you need to change. So with us, it's the login response, but it could also be the register response or anything like that. You can put those in here too. So we'll say this app singleton. And then it'll be login response contract class login response class. Okay, so now we are now registering our new login response. So we do need to import that up top. So for us, it's going to be use app HTTP. Responses login response. Okay, and now because we put this in as a function, we need to call this function somewhere. So up in this register method, we're just going to say this register response bindings. Okay, and now it's registered. So now this isn't going to work just yet. It's not going to work because if we go back down to our Laravel vendor file, okay? If you go to the authenticated session controller in here, this is what the app is using to handle the login process, okay? So as you can see, you can log out, you can log in, but these are these are being called from this authenticated session controller. Now, I always say never ever change the vendor files. Always pull out the file and then customize that file in one of your app folders. Okay, so that's exactly what we're gonna do. We're gonna take this whole controller, so copy. We're gonna head back up to our app, and in controllers, we're gonna create a new folder, and we're gonna call it auth. Okay, and in this auth folder, now we can go ahead and paste that controller that we just copied. Okay, open that one up, and now this one is gonna be app HTTP controller. Okay, and as you can see, this is using the standard login response that we're trying to override. So we need to change this now to we need to change it to app HTTP responses. Okay, so that it can now recognize our brand new login response instead of the one that we're trying to override. Okay, so you know what? This should be responses. Okay, so now that that's done, what we need to do is also override the login route. Okay, so what we can do is head back to the vendor file. We can open up the routes. It'll be Laravel fortify routes route.php, and we'll copy the whole thing. We're going to take mostly everything out, but this will just be the easiest thing. So we'll grab that, make sure I copied it, and then we'll open up web.php routes. These are now in our current route files. Okay, so we're not using any of these, so we can get rid of all of these. We can get rid of all of these. All of this. Shrink that. Shrink that. Shrink that. And get rid of all this. And we can get rid of this one, this one, this one, this one. This whole email verification. And we don't have to touch the register because that works just fine. And there are a lot of routes in here. Okay, so we can get rid of the password resets. Now again, if you want to customize any of these, you're more than welcome to. We don't need to do it for this demo. Okay, so now we're not going to need this two-factor thing here. And we don't need this create page. We don't need enable views. And now we have everything else is the same, limiter equals, login, authenticated session controller. So now we can use this one that we just created. Okay, so that one's gonna be in the app HTTP. Okay, so guest, limiter, all that should just be fine. Let's fix this up a little bit. Okay, fantastic. So now let's go ahead and try this and see if it works. So we'll go back to our app, we'll refresh. We will log out this admin. Okay, and now we'll go ahead and try to log back in, and we should go straight to the admin dashboard. So admin at admin.com, password, enter, target class, controller. Did I not import it? Authenticated session controller. Okay, so this should be, we have it in the auth folder. So auth. Okay, so it should work now. So we'll go back, we'll refresh, and we'll try it again. Okay, so we'll say admin at admin.com, password, auth controllers. Okay, let's see. Controllers auth authenticated. This should be auth. Okay, so third time's a charm. We'll go back. We'll refresh. Admin at admin.com, password. Okay, fantastic. So as you can see up here, we are now in the admin dashboard and all is good. So now let's log out and try to, well, let's grab a user first. So user, we'll just use this one. So copy, and now let's go ahead and log out. Log in. Paste. Password. Fantastic. And now we are at the standard users dashboard page. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and leave it there for now. In the next episode, we are going to start limiting what the admins can do, where they can go, what they can, you know, do throughout the admin pages. Okay, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.